So you're probably aware that there's two Lightrooms. There's Lightroom and there's Lightroom Classic. In this video, I'm going to briefly show you the difference, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to sync photos from Lightroom Classic with Lightroom, and it can trickle down into all your devices. And then I've got a really cool trick where I can show you how to automatically bring photos into the entire ecosystem. So if you've been using Lightroom for a long time, you remember there was just one Lightroom. It actually started off as Project Lightroom, then it became Lightroom. Somewhere along the line, they created another one called Project Nimbus. Maybe you remember that. And that was a mobile version of Lightroom. So professionals kind of kept using Lightroom while Nimbus developed and grew and started to get more features. Then with a very confusing announcement, Adobe said, hey, Lightroom is now going to be called Lightroom Classic. It's not going away. We're not retiring it, but we are going to keep the desktop Lightroom as Lightroom Classic. So then what was known as Lightroom Mobile and went on to be known as Lightroom CC for a while just became a Lightroom, which is what it is today. So this is Lightroom Classic. We're going to go back to this in just a second. But first of all, there's four parts of Lightroom. There's Lightroom, the desktop app. Then there's a Lightroom on the iPad. We have a Lightroom on the mobile phone. And then there's a Lightroom for the web. Now, all of these four Lightrooms all work together. They share the same library, which is synced in the cloud. So if I upload one photo to one of these devices, it syncs and it's available everywhere. I can also run it on an iPhone as well as an Android phone at the same time, and they will also sync. So here's the thing. When I upload a photo, it syncs with all the other ones and they all get the photo. If I make an adjustment on one, that adjustment will trickle through the entire system and everything will be updated at the same time. All right, so let's bring us to Lightroom Classic. Where does that fit in? For many people, maybe you don't want to sync your images in the cloud, or just at least not all your images. So you're working on Lightroom Classic. This is the Lightroom we've known and loved for many years. So we can create a bridge between Lightroom Classic here and the other Lightroom, where we can actually have images go backwards and forwards between the two ecosystems. Let me show you how. So under the collection, I'm going to create a new collection. I'm going to create a collection and I'm going to call this one LR Sync. Now, if you want, you can set this as a target collection. You don't have to, but you can. And we're going to choose Sync with Lightroom. I'm going to turn it as a target collection and I'm going to choose Create. So if we see now, it's created a selection. That little plus just means that I've got it as a target collection. You can change this at any time, but the nice thing about the target collection is, see these little dots? If you tap on the dots, those will get added. Normally it would just go into quick collection, but you can set that as a target collection here. And then if we look under the sync, we'll see those three photos have now been added. Of course, I can just drag there as well. That's another option. Now the way this works is because, see this little arrow here, or this little lightning bolt, means it's syncing. What you need to do is go up the top here too and turn on syncing. So if you pause syncing or turn it off, it's not going to work. Now, all the images that you have here are not going to sync unless you have this little lightning. So I can actually go to any collection. And if I click on there, that collection will sync with Lightroom. Now, we're just going to do this. Why don't we go to the other Lightroom? And if you look on the left, if you don't see this little option, click on there, that opens things up. This top part is all about, you know, sharing and stuff like that. That's more community. And you go under here, all photos. This is where all your photos live. So look at this. The LR Sync has been created. And those photos that I added are now available there. Same thing with the iPad and the phone. Okay, let's grab another photograph. Now, if we look at this one here, you'll notice that I've made adjustments on this. See how those are not in a neutral position? That's great. So what we could do is we could just tap on that little thing to add it to the collection, or if you didn't set that up as a target collection, which the T key, by the way, you just select a collection, tap on T, we'll set that. And I could also just tap the B key, would actually just add that. Those are some keyboard shortcuts, but let's just manually drag this in just so we can see. So we see we've got the three images. Let's take this image, drag it in, release. It's not creating another copy. All it's doing is it's just pointing at the metadata and say, hey, you know what? Sync this photo. Let's go to Lightroom. And of course, make sure up here we've got this on. You can see we're syncing. And there's our image. Okay. So if we look at these images and we look at the adjustments, you can see that these are neutral. No changes have been made. Now, if we pop this one open, look at this. Changes have been made, and these changes are reflected in here. So, you know, if we wanted to make more adjustments, like maybe let's take a little bit of dehaze, just give it a little pop there. And that tends to darken the shadows. So let's just take our blacks and we're just going to roll those back a little bit to compensate. Let's have a look on the phone. Okay, so here we are in Lightroom. We're just going to hit the little arrow. It shows all the different collections and things. And if we go here, is LR Sync. There's all the images. Let's pop open our image we've been looking at. And you can see we've got adjustments down here. So we could tap on things like light, so we can make it brighter, could make it darker. Let's go into color. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to warm it up a little bit just so we can see the difference. All right. Let's make it very quite radically different. There we go. Let's go to the tablet. And then we can see it's updated here on the iPad as well. So let's just fix that temperature a little bit. And as you can see, all those adjustments are there. So if we just reset the white balance again, just double clicking, we can take that back to how it was. So let's go back to Lightroom Classic. And there we go, we can see that's updated. Okay, let me show you a trick here where we can drop photos into a folder and they're gonna go into the entire system onto all the devices in Lightroom and Lightroom Classic. So let's go to the desktop or wherever you want to do it. We're going to right click and create a new folder. I'm going to call this LR Sync. So under Lightroom Classic, we choose File and we go down to Auto Import. Let's choose Auto Import Settings. Now what we want to do is change the watch folder to the one that we created. So there's LR Sync. We're choosing that as our watch folder. Now destination. Now you could choose to put these where your other photos are, but for now I'm just going to do test. But put it to your photo library and then click choose. So what it's going to do is once we drop them into that folder, it's going to move them into that location to store them. So that would be where you normally save your photos. Then here's where the clincher is, add to collection. Under the add to collection, choose the LR sync and click OK. Everything is set up. So now all we need to do is just choose File, Auto Import, and we enable Auto Import. Now, of course, you could have also set that in the previous box. Let's see how it works. Let's just grab something random. This was me on the grid. So this is not going to look like my other photos. So this should work quite nicely. Let's just drop it into the LR Sync folder. All right. So we're going to scroll down. Let's find our LR Sync folder and look at that. There's the image that I bought in there. And let's go through to the other Lightroom and see if it's in there. And because that folder is synced, notice now it's in here, which means if I go to my iPad, I go to my phone, it's also going to be there because now it's inside this ecosystem. So let's make it interesting. Can we get a photo from the other Lightroom ecosystem into Lightroom Classic? Well, you probably guessed the answer is yes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in here. I'm going to grab another one of my photos that I've taken previously. And I'm just going to drag this into my LR sync. You'll see it shows up in here. Now it's syncing with the iPad, with the iPhone, with the Android phone as well. And of course, the web app. And it's syncing with Lightroom Classic. And here we are in Lightroom Classic. There's the photos. The adjustments that I make anywhere are going to trickle through. So just remember the limitations are I can only share from one catalog. So when I'm in this catalog, I can go to any collection, I can go to different groups, I can go to different places, and I can sync those photos where they're going to be moved into the cloud and shared through that entire ecosystem. Now remember, only the ones I choose to sync are the ones that are going to sync. So as always, drop a comment and let me know if you learned anything new. Also, would you like to see me do more tutorials on the Lightroom or just stick to Lightroom Classic? Let me know your preferences underneath. And also, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any videos from me. And do me a favor, hit the like button as a thumbs up. Helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.